Happy Pizza Wednesday, everybody. Woot! Since I'm not stuffing a bird tomorrow, I'm going to stuff the pizza. Rue likes the sound of that. Yeah. You heard food and, you know, the good, happy sounds. Yeah. How's it going? Yeah, it's a good boy. A little rainy here. He's just chilling downstairs. Boy, I bet we're all going to invent some new rituals this holiday season, right? I don't really have anything planned tomorrow. I'm certainly thinking about other rituals, and one in particular that me and my friend Matt have subscribed to is playing this record. Usually the day before Thanksgiving, or, you know, right around this time. Great Irish band that Matt and I were roommates at the time, and this was the early 90s, and we stumbled down the street to see them play at Martyrs. I think we saw them a couple times. I think the first time I saw them was when the stage was, when the club was new and the stage was on the, like, the south side of the room, right? Where the big bar is now. And then they got the big stage on the kind of north side of it now. I think I saw them twice. I could be blurring some gigs together. But, you know, and this song just captures that, you know, back in those days, we just hang around the apartment for hours and look at the reader and figure out who's playing at what club and who was going to be where. And, you know, after a bunch of drinking, you know, you'd hit the you'd hit the cold night air about 10:30, and the evening was just starting. Yeah, this band, I had such a blast watching this band. They had a keyboard player on tour with them, this tall, lithe wisp of a fellow. Check out this name. I gotta look up here and read it. Give me a second. I blew it. I hid the page here. I got it. This keyboard player's name, Alistair Ardingstall. And he looked every inch of it. This guy is mesmerizing. He's playing keyboards, and he just had this deft grace to him where he just acted completely nonchalant. You know, it was half like Ron Mayall from Sparks and half I don't know what. It was fantastic. I was riveted to this guy. And then Tim Bradshaw and Dermot Lynch from that band went on to do some amazing work with David Gray down the road and a bunch of other cool artists. That was after they had been briefly waylaid for a few years by an American singer-songwriter, but yeah. It's a great record. If you don't know this one, you should try to find a copy. It's really cool. Yeah. And so I'm going to do this song today and send it out to my buddy Matt and all the friends that were there that night and all the adventures we were having, cavorting around in the snow and the holiday cheer in Chicago, and hope you all just have a safe, joyous Thanksgiving, and everybody be great.
And the girls go out and it's a date. and the boys stay in, now it's too late. Still I fall in love 6 times a night, in vain on sight, in vain on sight. And this bottle laughs back in my face. See how easily I lose my place, and the way I look tonight's a crime. Where does the time go? Where has the time gone? What if I held you in my arms again? This time I'd never let you go, and I would feel the universe for you, and I would let you know. Letters, leases, writs and rings. And when the last one's sold or lost or gone, we don't belong here, we don't belong here. But if I held you in my arms again, this time I'd never let you go. Dust me down. Things would always have turned out about this way. Where there's an up, there'll always be a down, you say. Where there's an up, there'll always be a down. What if I held you in my arms again? This time I'd never let you go. I would let you know if I had you.